Positive selection of bacterial colonies during DNA cloning. Oftentimes, during DNA cloning, we'll need a method to determine if our host cells have taken up a vector. In this example, we'll try to transform our host E. coli cells with a plasmid. The method that we'll use to introduce our plasmid into our host cells, usually transformation, is not 100% efficient, so not all of our cells will take up our plasmid. If I were able to look at the contents of my host cells, I would see that some of my host cells took up the plasmid while others did not. But how can we tell? One way we can accomplish this is through a process known as selection. Selection is a process where we can determine if our cells have taken up DNA based on whether or not our cells live or die. It is literally a matter of life or death. Selection can be broken down into two types, positive selection and negative selection. Positive selection permits the growth of cells that have successfully taken up your DNA of interest, while negative selection kills them. Wait, did you say that negative selection kills the cells that have successfully taken up our DNA of interest? Oh yes, yes I did. And I'll explain why we might want to do this in the next video. Let's go over an example of positive selection first. Now let's pretend that we have a vector that we want our host E. coli cells to take up through transformation. Let's pretend that our vector is a plasmid, which contains the gene often denoted as AMPR, or the ampicillin resistance gene. This gene encodes for the protein product beta-lactamase. Beta-lactamase degrades beta-lactam antibiotics like ampicillin. Normally, ampicillin will kill E. coli, but if beta-lactamase is present, it will degrade the ampicillin, allowing the E. coli to survive. Now, let's pretend that we mix our plasmid together with our E. coli cells and perform a transformation just like at the beginning of the video. We then plate our E. coli on a media containing ampicillin and allow them to grow. The E. coli that did not take up a plasmid die, since the ampicillin will kill them. The E. coli that have taken up a plasmid and produced beta-lactamase will survive. This is an example of positive selection, because the uptake of your DNA of interest allows your host cells to survive. I hope this helps. Best of luck with studying. Here are some previous videos that you can check out. Soon, there will also be a link to the second part of this video on negative selection. If you have any suggestions for what my next video should be about, leave a comment to let me know.